Hey guys, welcome back to my playthrough of the Witcher DLC story, Blood and Wine. Just before this, I did a bit of a side mission just to take care of it. I had to repair my sword, because I had to kill one of those Xiaomers, or whatever, how you pronounce them. I'm just so lucky that I freaking had a backup sword. There's the only thing we need to just loot everything. You don't care what you need, you just loot everything. Just gotta talk to this.
So how would you explain it? Whether it pours for a week or the sun bakes our pates, we've always mud up to our ankles here.
You can't blame me for Beauclerc's fickle weather.
Fickle weather? I've seen you. You empty your chamber pot in front of our shop each morn, so folks with dirt in their boots go to you to get them cleaned.
A far-fetched conspiracy theory, sirs.
I'll conspire to welt your bum with my belt. Come here.
Leave him alone.
Just who the spit are you?
Let's just scare him a
Witcher,
bit.
And I'd advise you to go back where you came from.
I thought witches defend men from monsters, not cheats from justice.
Need to talk to the boy.
You can chat to him all you like, after we tan his hide. So stand down.
Not gonna happen.
Won't it? Well, then we'll thrash you as well, which is all the same to me.
Alright. Really? Really? I can't use the sword or like convince them? Oh, a heavy punch should do the trick. You bitch. Yeah. Yeah. Eat shit. Eat shit, dick. You don't pick on a kid, dude.
What's the meaning of this? The brawl? Who started it?
I'm investigating the beast on the Duchess's orders.
Ah, yes. We've heard of you. And this man. What are they doing?
Obstructing my investigation.
Understood. Right. A few days in the clink ought to teach them not to impede official duchy business. Come on.
You're very good with your fists, sir. Wouldn't be looking for work, would you? We'd make a fine duo.
Yeah, how you imagine that working?
Splendidly, that's how. I suggest a partnership, where I see to the boots while you stand guard, and as you're the stronger, come morning you take the chamber pot out and help me make mud.
Bit about the mud's true. They were right to want to box your ears.
I've got to make a living somehow, so what say you, sir?
Let me think about it. Listen, I'm interested in a certain gentleman.
Wait! Before we get to talking, please, take a seat.
But my boots are clean.
In this city, no boots are clean unless they've just come off my stout.
Alright,
So then, who was it you wanted to ask about?
One of your patrons. Tall, elegant black frock, not from around here.
A rival? Indeed. Faint bell ringing. A modest sum might make it sing out loud and clear.
How much?
Let's say...
What? Gotta be...
Expand my venture. I'm sure you can imagine. Have a proper stand with a big sign. I want a new box, too.
Got it.
I should think so.
Oh, I'll do it.
All right.
He's just a kid.
Let's see if we can't figure
something out. I've got heaps of money.
Shit.
Guess I can agree to that.
A thousand thanks. I shan't forget it. I know the fellow you seek. though I don't know his name. A steady patron, gets his boots cleaned every few days. He's very good to me. Always pays me a premium.
Know where I might find him?
No, but you could wait here. Perhaps he'll stop by.
Don't have the time for that. Sure you don't know where to find him? Or maybe you notice which direction he came from?
When I clean boots, sir, I do not look up to see where folk come from. I clean.
It seems you're having a rough go of it.
Oh, you're here. Feeling better?
I am. The local necropolis. Now, if I might intercede, I dare say I've the right question to ask. Young man, you see this vial? One drop added to your boot polish will help you wipe even the most encrusted boot clean as the dome of St. Nebioda's Cathedral. With it, you will serve three times as many patrons at a fraction of the effort, and piles more coin. I'm prepared to give you this vial if you tell me where the man we seek lives.
But you won't hurt him, will you? The gentleman's art, true, but he's kind.
In point of fact, he's a friend. Yet we had a falling out of sorts and would like to straighten matters out.
I leave his boots at the door of a house near the port. The door is red, but I do not know if the gentleman lives there.
Worth checking. Might happen on a lead.
Would you let me scrape the dirt off your kickers before you go? With all due respect, sirs, your boots could stand a cleaning.
Thank you. Perhaps later.
I'm really hoping this ending is actually pretty good.
Handled that kid pretty well.
Finding the right approach. That's the trick to dealing with children.
Yeah, saw that. Meaning, the right thing to bribe them with.
Well, I feel like you're helping me out. I'm too kind in this game, so it's kind of cost me money. And as you can see, I've dyed all my manticore armor black, and I've got a manticore sword. I'm not sure what the... I think it's not the Hammond sword. It was my main steel sword. I've got to get to them. Like, they've made armor awesome.
The boot black mentioned.
Alright,
is that a witch murdering folk?
Gotta break it down.
You might just as well stand out in the street, pound on a drum and holler, Detlaf, I'm coming for you. A bit more finesse, I implore you.
Let's hear your idea.
Give me a moment.
Nice. Ever consider becoming a burglar? Skill like that would come in awful handy.
I considered it briefly, but ultimately concluded it would be terribly dull. Come.
Sense him.
No, he's not here, but he was here recently. His scent is still strong.
Let's look around.
Alright, let's look around. I want this to be like a good story, like this. Isolation. See, that's what I mean. I just freaking take everything.
No use to anyone. Shame. Must have brought someone joy sometime.
Eviction notice.
Somebody fixed this recently.
Let's go upstairs.
Attic. Let's go. So this is his nest. Need to look around.
Suspicious letter.
Detlaf van der Heretane, you do not know us, but we know you to be a vampire. We know also of your weakness for the wench they call Renowed. Now you know this. We shall chain her down and let rats feed on her. We shall flay the skin from her flesh. Yet you can save her. You need but travel to Beauclair, where you shall slay 5 men in the manner we prescribe. You must complete the killing in 3 days. Fail, and the next
thing
you receive will contain a memento of your failure. Your beloved's finger.
There you have it. Proof positive Detlaf killed not of his own accord. What would have sunk his claws into him?
Any idea what it could be? Detlaf have any enemies?
Indeed. Detlaf gains foes occasionally, but they never live long.
One might have managed to evade him.
Possible in theory, but I know of none. It would have to be someone devilishly dangerous. As you well know, having faced Detlaf yourself, whoever it is someone new.
Who's Renowed?
His one-time mother. The sole human woman with whom he was very close. Because she accepted him. With her aid and care, he found a place for himself in this hostile world. She began the work.
He really is hostile, though.
Ever meet her?
Never had the pleasure of us. She deserted him the time before he came around to save her, though he always claimed she'd gone missing.
Take it you have your doubts.
I know humans better than others. Their capacity to be disloyal, dishonest. I also know she took her home to. Not something one associates with the kidnapped, or those who disappear against their will.
I'll save you the trouble of asking. No, I don't know why she left. I can, however, hazard a guess that Detlaf grew angry one day, showed another, more monstrous side. Detlaf's anger could frighten anyone off, though most who see it get no chance to flee.
Detlaf have trouble letting go, accepting that she'd left him?
Is that so hard to believe? Do you know no humans who've struggled with just such a thing? And Detlaf is so much more emotional than most humans. Not only was she his beloved, his lover, his mate, she was a member of his pack. And one never leaves one's pack voluntarily.
Even if Renowed did abandon him that time, looks like someone's actually kidnapped her this time.
Hard to argue with that. And hard to foresee what he's prepared to do to free her. Get her back.
He's prepared to kill, that's clear.
As would you be for Yennefer.
Alright, sorry that you can do the banging next door.
He cares for her deeply. And that blood, those individuals, they mean nothing to him.
Yeah, I get it now. He's out to rescue a female from his pack.
Exactly.
Right, so someone's blackmailing him. We know that. Still have no idea who. Need to look him.
Guys, I'm back. I just had to get a quick drink.
Tools were used recently. Detlaf unwind by fixing toys between murders.
Really, no direct mischief.
Nice tune.
Indeed. Not certain why, but it reminds me of home. My true home from before the conjunction of spheres.
Alright.
Look, slips of paper, name on each. Count Crespi, Count Dulac, Milton de Peyrac Peyrin, Count de Lacroix.
Detlaf's victims, one and all. But that's not his hand.
Must have come from whoever wrote the letter. All of it written using the same ink.
Alright. I hope you guys are enjoying my Witcher 3 series. I'm sorry I haven't done it in a while.
Ink was dyed with cinnabarite. Rare mineral. Found only on
Nazaire, but I fear it means very little. Anyone could have imported such ink.
Fair enough. Still worth remembering.
The slip is stained.
With wine. Not much to go on either, especially not in Beauclair.
Perhaps. Yet perhaps also worth remembering.
Let's sum up what we know. Seems Detlaf's being blackmailed. Someone's been feeding him his victims' names.
All noted down using one and the same Nazaire ink. and not in his handwriting.
Not much.
But enough to ascertain Detloff's innocence, clearly.
I think it's true.
Actually, it is. Detloff's being manipulated. Some lunatics turned him into a tool, making him kill.
So it would seem. But this illuminates a path of action for us. We must find Renouet. Render the blackmail senseless. The lunatic or ticks will thus lose hold on Detloff.
That's one idea. Could be worth a shot. But what about Detloff? You gonna go on killing while I'm out searching for his lover?
He will not. I shall convince him to stay his hand. Assure him you're a friend seeking to help. I'll await him here. Be sure to return sooner or later.
Think he'll listen?
He will.
Pot a wit with you, maybe.
No. He'll sense you from a mile off. Simply fail to appear. I'd better stay alone. You must trust me on this.
Fine. Need to report to the Duchess first.
So be it. We'll await you here. Detloff and I both.
Alright. To the Duchess. So it's kind of a love story, but more blackmail, which I kind of like. Because I do want the DLC to be the same story as last time. So what should I upgrade? Because I know I'm going to need it. I really don't really care about the... Alright then. Upgrade that. Because I'm more of a fan of the fire magic stuff. Oh, I should use my horse. I don't like fast traveling a lot. This feels off. Because you got to admire the background in this game. It really is good. It might have been toned down in the first, in the Witcher 3. But still good for its... Yeah, I'm just captured by it. So we'd sneeze. No, hiccup, not sneeze. And I think this got DLC of the year. I think it deserves it so far. But what annoys me is The Division got the Game of the Year for 2016. I think the Division was a good game. It certainly wasn't great. I think it had a bit too many negatives, but not too many to overrule it. It's kind of evened out the positives in the game, but... But for my games of the year, I think it had to be Far Cry Primal, Doom, Uncharted 4. I really can't say that just yet after until I finished the game. I just actually recorded the Uncharted the Thieves End Part 1 just then, but whether I upload it, I don't know. And that's another game that's actually intrigued me. Battlefield 1's up there. Call of Duty Remastered, but hasn't really. Campaign, it was good to see what it looked like in today's graphics, but... Yeah, it's good, but the multiplayer really hasn't stood up for me, so I think... That's what just annoys me when bloody companies like IGN say games are perfect, but they actually don't review the games properly. I like The Division, I'm not shooting on it, I just feel like they could have done a better job. I'll do it in my review, Actually, I don't know what I'm going to do in my reviews until I get more views. Doing this much running is annoying sometimes.
Would you guess this champion?
Of Rivia, Master Witcher. I was not mistaken. You arrived and trouble followed soon after.
Step aside. Got a matter for the Duchess.
At last, Witcher. We've been on tenterhooks. Did you catch Milton's killer?
case is more serious than we thought. The beast, we couldn't kill it, didn't manage.
We sent you after a monster, and you return with nothing? We are very disappointed.
Situation's not quite that simple. Beast's a powerful vampire.
Is this a problem? Is it too much for a witcher? Monster slayer? But everyone knows how to end a vampire. Draw him by trick into sunlight. Or arm yourself with ample garlic and drive a stake through its heart.
Garlic's useless against vampires. Sun and stakes don't hurt him either. Those methods, pure invention, only work in legends and fables.
And buckthorn? When I was a child, Grandmama Admarta always claimed buckthorn drives off vampires.
Silver sword's your best option for keeping them at bay. But it won't get the job done, because only a higher vampire can truly kill another of its kind.
Excuses? Ha! Your Grace, I shall assemble a battue. Bring the matter to its end at once. The Witcher need but tell us where to find this monster.
Whoa, this is work for a Witcher, not for your guardsmen.
Yet when a Witcher fails, my guardsmen must step in. I'll take my best. 40 hardened veterans. No vampire can stand up to that.
40, 50, 100? Doesn't matter. Won't make any difference against him.
You have not seen my guardsmen in action.
Can they fight fog? Hit a target that moves faster than the wind?
How? What creature can do such things?
Creatures like this one. Higher vampires, we call them. Each one's a little different. Unique or exceptional, you might say. Some transform into giant bats. Others communicate with animals, command them.
Yet all are still brainless beasts.
Dead wrong. Thinking of lesser vampires, Alps, Ekimaras, Catacans, for instance. They're ruled by instinct, sure. Attack anything that smells of blood. Higher vampires? They think. They employ reason.
Monsters driven by reason. A curious contention. What then do you intend to do?
Try to talk to him. That's our best bet.
I cannot believe this. Her Grace summons a Witcher to kill a monster. Instead, he wishes to chat with it.
Know what I'm doing. His lover was kidnapped. He's being blackmailed.
Blackmail? Be so kind as to explain how a vampire might be blackmailed.
Higher vampires? They're like us, motivated by emotions, not instinct. Not only are they intelligent to an extreme, they're emotionally rich, capable of feeling many things, even love. This one fell in love with a woman, a human, and he'll do anything to keep her from harm.
You do not, I trust, suggest we let Milton's killer go free, or wait until it murders again. We must render it harmless as quickly as possible.
Which is why that's my aim now. To prevent further attacks. Vampires only half the problem. Blackmailers at fault chiefly. Kidnap the woman to control the vampire.
And what do you propose to do?
I'll find the blackmailer, free the vampire's lover.
You were to destroy him, not help him.
No one else should die. That's most important. As soon as the woman's safe, he'll have no more reason to kill.
I admit to being swayed, Witcher. You may be right. Do you know anything about the blackmailer?
Got one lead. A few scraps of paper. Blackmailer wrote the names of the vampire's victims on them. One of them stained. A drop of wine, looks like. So damn little to go on.
You've no idea how well I know you. Send for the Ducal Sommelier. Hop, hop! In Tucson, wine is sacred. Here there is no such thing as a drop of wine, or stains therefrom. They are stains from a drop of Estest, Ervelus, Fiorano.
Your Grace wished to see me?
Witcher, show him the paper scrap. Benoit, can you determine which wine made this stain?
Yes. Yes. The west bank of the Saint Latour. That's rather obvious. Aged in barrels of Beauclair oak. Hue, deep burgundy. Clarity, high. It's simple. Saint Real, the 1269 vintage.
That's impossible. The wine is produced at Castel Ravenna. Especially and exclusively for the ducal table. Perhaps some Saint Real was stolen. We must go to the vineyard. See if there's not been an incident.
Wait.
I hope you do not suppose we will sit on our ducal hiney and...
Your Grace, what you propose is far too dangerous. The Witcher should go alone.
It pleases me to see you gentlemen finally agree on something. But I've made my decision. We shall go, accompanied by the best possible escorts. You, Captain, and Geralt. We will travel incognito. We've no wish to give the court any reason to gossip. For the duration of this mission, I release you from your obligation to adhere to court protocol. In short, from now on, I am Anna Henrietta, not your Grace.
Yes, your Grace. Witcher, are you ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah, ready to go.
Excellent. Give me a moment. I must don something more appropriate and concealing. Then we will be off.
All right. Sure, I can either bang on the next door. Hurry up, loading screen.
Come on, this vampire. Have you ever faced its sort before?
I have.
How did it end? Did you kill it?
Didn't have to fight him. Hadn't killed anyone.
Have you ever heard of anyone defeating such a vampire?
Know of a man who defeated one, sure, but he didn't manage to kill it. Ultimately, only another vampire can kill a vampire.
Thank you. You saved our lives.
Hooray!
Tell me more about this vineyard, Castel Ravenna.
It's the best in Ortusa. An old master of the winemaking trade runs it. Fabrizio.
You trustworthy?
He's held his post for years. There's never been a problem. Till now. I wish to know your thoughts, Carol. The Saint Real stain, how did it wind up on the paper? Is someone from the vineyard blackmailing the vampire?
could be a servant, could be the steward, could be the one who just stole from the estate.
Get up! Why do you flee?
Whoa there, Roach.
You call that escorting her illustrious highness? What were you thinking?
Captain, this is not the time for such complaints. As for you, Witcher, next time, keep close.
Captain de la Tour, we did not expect any visitors from the palace. How are affairs at court?
Doubtless you've heard of the Beast of Beauclair. Well, we've our hands full. Especially since the rogue last attacked in the palace gardens.
Aye. Trust her illustrious highness was not harmed.
Kind of you to ask, Master Fabricio. I am well.
Your grace? You were not warned. I shall order the salon prepared at once.
That won't be necessary. As you can see, we are not here on an official visit.
Naturally. Might I ask then what has brought you to Castel Ravello?
Got some questions.
In this land, it is seen as polite to introduce oneself before asking any questions.
This is Geralt of Rivia, a witcher. He has come to Toussaint on my personal invitation. Which is to say, I expect you to treat him with the utmost respect.
Of course, Your Grace.
Did you hear that, Witcher? Fabricio will be delighted to answer your every question.
Want to talk about Sanreal?
I am at your service.
Some of this wine might have been stolen. Just a suspicion we have, but any burglaries lately?
Burglaries? Not to my knowledge. And a few days past, I took stock of the inventory. All was accounted for. The barrels lie safely in the cellar, I assure you.
The Sanreal. How many vineyard workers have access to it?
One might say only I do.
Not like you make the wine all alone. At least a dozen others work here.
I see you've little notion how wine is made. Grapes travel a long road before they become Sanreal. The workers assist me only to the stage of fermentation. I see to the maceration personally, and let no one near the fat. Workers, again, assist me during barreling, but then I seal the aging barrels myself, each and every one. The wine lies in the cellar, gains character. Once this process is complete, it becomes Sanreal. And as it happens, only I have the key to the cellar in question.
We'll not get anywhere asking questions, I...
Your Grace? How am I to understand this?
Master Fabricio, we have proof someone's gained access to Sanreal. Someone who should not have, which means one of two things. Either you lie to our face, or you are an idiot who has had wine stolen from under his nose and not even realized it! You shall answer for it.
But...
Silence! And listen. I shall inspect the barrels in person, thus giving you time to reflect. When I return, I expect to hear answers. Remind me, where is the Sanreal stored?
In the main cellar, around the corner. I'll show you.
I shall find it. Give me the key to the cellar and wait here.
Oh, of course, Your Grace. Here it is.
Come, Witcher.
What if Fabricio's blackmailing the vampire? Consider that?
He has his flaws, but I would never suspect him of such a thing. He's been very loyal. He owes all he has to me. His father frittered away the family fortune. He left his son an encyclopedic knowledge of wine, That is good. Fabrizio lived as a beggar until I appointed him steward of Castel Ravello. Only then did he come into his own.
So where do we start?
Let us see if all the barrels are present. Here's the inventory ledger.
Alright, so I like how wine is the main theme.
Vintner's log. Fermentation completed with no complications. Tapped above sediment line. Here it is, barreling. Everything lines up at first glance. Neatly and thoroughly documented.
Then we must follow our other lead. Benoit said the stain came from the 1269 vintage. Let's find it.
I'm sorry you can hear my sister arguing. It's annoying.
Everloose. I like it. Quite dry.
An excellent wine. You've good taste.
Est. I think everyone and their mothers heard of this wine.
Among the best in the world. Castel Ravello is famous for it.
Alright. Fiorano.
Fiorano. Dandelion's favorite. Adores it.
Ah, yes. That sophisticated palate of his.
Panama 1973.
Got Pomino over here.
Sonis.
San Real. 1270 vintage.
That's the wrong year. Keep looking.
San Real. Barrels are dated 1268.
Close, but not quite the right year.
I think this is it. 1969, yep. Found it.
Right here. 1269. What now?
Let's see if any barrels are empty.
Want to open them?
For now, a lock will suffice. If you hear a hollow thud, we will have found what we seek.
Full. This one's full, too. This one's full, too.
So everything's...
Looks like all the barrels are full. Dead end, I'm afraid.
Full they are. The question is, are they full of sangria? Grab a tap and a hammer. We shall open them one by one on taste.
Some barrel taps. Yeah, I'm too lazy to take shortcuts. Once again, I apologize for my sister. Can't. Barrel tap.
Barrel taps. Got the taps.
Then get to work. Let's broach those barrels.
Ready.
Step aside. I'd recognize this taste anyway. This one is good.
All right. Yeah, that one's it.
Revolting, bitter plonk.
Could have gone sour while aging.
Impossible. This is not wine. This is contaminated refuse that should never have made it into a barrel. The fact that it did was no accident, I'm sure.
Master Fabricio, let's see what he has to say about it.
And tells me he's not there.
Disappointed.
But your grace, I...
You are a step away from losing your head. Speak the truth and you might yet keep it.
I admit it. I sold a barrel of Sorial. I beg you to forgive me.
Yep, that is not him.
I couldn't resist. The sum they offered, it was enormous. I gave in.
Is what I provide not enough?
I wished to buy back my family's estate. For here, nothing is truly mine. I've a roof over my head, ample food to eat, but what is a nobleman without land of his own? I shall tell you everything, if you agree to show me mercy.
Who'd you sell the wine to?
A few weeks past, at the pheasantry, a rich nobleman approached me. He called himself a diplomat, well-connected at court. He suggested we embark on an enterprise. Some of his clients had offered dizzying sums for even a drop of Sorial. He was to serve as intermediary.
This man's name?
He never revealed it. He was tall, black-haired, and spoke with a foreign lilt. He claimed to hail from Sintra.
I've no Sintrian aristocrat at court.
Wine itself. How do you hand it over?
We met under the cover of darkness in the ruins of Fort Astra. A dozen or so men came to collect. Armed men. The kind that stink of trouble. I had hauled the barrel there. They transferred it to their cart, and we went our separate ways.
That's it? At the last you ever saw of them?
That is to say,